Hi, welcome to Linux Shell tutorial. Today we are going to discuss about some of useful command line tricks in Linux. Let me see how to use the command line tricks in Linux, and also this tutorial will be useful for beginner. Let me see how to use this command line tricks. Now the first command is midnight commander, so it is easy to view the virtual shell in your terminal. So before that, I'm going to show some demos. If you want to create any files using touch and enter your file name, and if you want to copy any name, you can use cp, and if you want to modify your or move your text or files using mv command. So these are the basic command we are using in command line. Now I am going to show how to do this configuration in graphically. Let me see how to do this. You should install midnight commander package by using m install mc. It's short form for midnight commander. So once you enter your package, let me see how to use this. I am already installed my mc package. So now I am going to execute my mc command. So type mc, now hit enter. This is your midnight commander terminal. Now your terminal mc terminal will be opened, that is midnight commander terminal will be opened. Now I am going to show how to use this terminal. Suppose I am going to edit this my.txt file. So here edit option is there. You press just this edit button. If you want to edit anything, you just type. So already four content is there. So I'm going to add another content. So after added this content, you can save by clicking save option and click save. So if you want to quit this page, you can quit by using option 10. So now it back to normal terminal. So you can easily edit your file in graphically by using this mc commander. And also if you want to move, or you can zip your file, or you can remove or delete your file by using this terminal. Now I am going to show how to copy the text file to any other directory in this mc commander. Just click the file and press copy button. So which location if you want to copy, so enter that location and which path if you want to copy, and also the directory name. So I am going to copy at my dir directory. So hit enter, click OK. Now so it will be copied to my dir. So if you want to verify, means go and open that my dir file. So again, if you want to create any other directory, means plus mkdir. So if you type your directory name, so I'm going to type folder. So now click OK. So your folder directory will be created. So if you want to remove the directory, means click the folder and press delete. Press yes. So your folder will be created, directory will be deleted. So this is the method to use mc commander, that is midnight commander. So if you want to, if you have any doubt, if you want to search, means press F2. So your manual page will be opened. Here you can verify your doubt here. So this is the method to use mc commander line. So now the next Linux trick tool is ls logins. So using ls login, you can list your Linux system user and some basic information about the users. So after enter this command, hit enter now. So it will be shows your Linux user details. So and also process and some basic information will be shown here. So this is the method to view your Linux system users by using ls logins. Now the next option is, so I'm going to find my files in specific directory by using find command. So enter your specific directory, which directory if you want to search the file, and also mention here syntax type, which it denotes you're going to search a file or directory. If we want to search file means press type F here. So after enter this command, hit enter now. So it will be listed entire files available in root and direct desktop location. So same procedure if you want to check directory means. So just simple, you had it just replace D instead of F. Now hit enter. So your result like this. So it will be shows your entire directory available in your root desktop directory. So this is a simple method to check your file and directory it is available in specific directory or location by using find. So by using same find option, you can search file based on size. Now the syntax to check your file based on size by using this command. So here enter your type and mention F for your file type. So here size, you should mention that particular size. So I mentioned 1 MB. So after enter this command, hit enter. So now the result will be shown like this. So here 1 MB or lesser than 1 MB files will be shown here. So if you want to check any 10 MB means you should enter 10 MB. If you want to check GB means you can enter the GB format. So that depends upon your wishes. This is one of the important usage in your find command. So and also find command have many more options that we see on later the commands. So now the next option is I'm going to create a directory tree. So normally if you want to create directory means usually you should use mkdir and enter any directory name, my new. So enter now. So your directory will be created. If you want to go means you can go by using cd and my new. So if you want to create directory inside this directory means, so again go to the my new directory. If you want to create directory tree under this directory means again you should use mkdir and my. So here my will be created in this directory. So again if you want to open means go to by using cd. So now hit enter again. If you want to create a directory means by using same mkdir and directory name, so it will be created, but the steps will be too long. So it will be wasting time. So simply I am going to create directory tree by using simple command. So just you should type mkdir and hyphen p. So now this is the simple way to create your directory tree by using mkdir and hyphen p. So this is my starting directory mkdir. Inside that directory tree, one is there, inside one, two is there and follows. So after enter this command, hit enter. So now your directory tree will be created. If you want to verify means list the file, list your directory. So your mk1 is there. So if you want to get brief information means type tree and mention that mk. Now hit enter. So now your directory tree will be shown here. So inside mk1 1 and inside 1 2, inside 2 2 3. And follows. So this all directories are empty directory, that's why no file is contained there, that's why here mentioned zero. So this is the method to create your parent directory by using mkdir option p and also review your result by using tree option. Now the next option is I'm going to copy single file into multi directories by using echo and following commands. So this is my multi directories with specified locations. So the here three directories be there in same location, and this is my text file. I am going to copy this single file into this locations, this three location. So after enter this command, hit enter. So now your text file will be copied to this three locations. So if you want to verify means go to that location root desktop. So open that cd dir one directory. So hit enter, list the directory. Text is there. My.txt is there. So again go to another directory, dir2. So hit enter again. List is there. So same, you can check that another directory also. So this is the method to copy your text file into multi directories by using following this command. This is the procedure to copy your single text file into multiple directories. So now the next option, I'm going to use cat and I'm going to view my.txt. So here the content of my.txt will be shown here. So now the concept is I'm going to remove this all contents from my.txt without deleting this my.txt by using following command. Use this symbol and type that my.txt. Now hit enter. So your file will be now empty. If you want to verify, means type cat and my.txt, enter your file name. So there is no content available. So this is the method to remove your file content without deleting the file by using this command. So now the next option is history command. It is very useful for Linux beginners. So now if you want to see the status, what kind of command you have done in last some minutes and also previous section, so hit enter now after enter this history command. So it will be shown until what are process you have done, which means what type of command you are used. In top to bottom it will be shown. If you want to view the specific command or command particular line, use that line by using infinity symbol and enter that ID number. I am going to view this 627. So type this 627 here. Now hit enter. So it will be shows that command executed output here. You can view your status by using this method also. Now the next option in history command is you can search by using Control plus R. So press Control plus R. So now you can search your commands by using this command also. So type which command if you want to search. So I'm going to search again ls. So now hit enter. So ls command will be executed, will be shown here. You can search by using this method also by using Control plus R. Now the next command is shutdown command. Now the next topic we're going to discuss about shutdown command. It also one of the important command to Linux user. So but it is very careful to use this shutdown command. So this command is used to shutdown your system in using Linux terminal. So here shutdown command have variety of option. If you want to shutdown with specific time and duration, so hit enter after pressing this shutdown means it will be immediately shutdown now. If you want to specific shutdown the system with specific time, means see your timing. I'm going to shutdown at 11 a.m. So this time it will be mentioned, means it will be shutdown at 11 a.m. So if you want to shutdown at specific time minutes, means plus 15 minutes I mentioned here. So it will shows plus 15 minutes. So after enter this command, your system will be shutdown after 15 minutes. So this is so many options available in shutdown. So this is the simple commands to use shutdown command. So these commands are basics for Linux user and beginners. So this is very useful to handling your Linux system. So that's all about this tutorial. Let me see you on another video. Thank you.